Warley, the National Model Railway Exhibition. So I'm Luke. If you know this, the layouts, you might know me, but if not, I'm usually the one behind the camera, but I've got the wonderful Matt helping me today, so there he is. But yeah, so we're going to have a little run around this, the biggest model railway show in the UK, as far as I'm aware. But yeah, so let's start at the home stand, where we've got the Farquhar branch, the model made by the Reverend Wilbert Audrey himself, featuring all of those iconic characters that you all know and love. So yeah, if we pop over here, Matt, I think there's some familiar faces here.
Oh God.
I'm going to hold this to you. Hello. Oh,
this is very strange to be on this end of it.
Yeah. This is Laurie Rose from Laurie Goes Loco.
Yeah.
You might know him, you might not.
You probably don't. This is the wrong kind of railways.
It is a bit more model for your things. So, yes. How have you been? You enjoying the show?
Loving it. It's great. There's lots of stuff here, including this stuff here. It's all rubbish stuff, you know. I don't know. Not my stuff at all.
Well, you weren't saying that, you know, a couple months ago.
No, this is great. It's something I've had a closer look at in... It was a while ago now, wasn't it?
Yeah,
it was
quite a bit.
But to the whole significance of what this is represents so much everything that we hold dear. This is a lot to answer for. Because of this and the phenomenon that follows it, I've got a loco, a channel, driving stuff. And it's all because of that. And that's mad. And
it's brilliant.
Yeah, it's absolutely insane. It's a good show. Have you walked around yet?
No. Well, we've had a quick look.
I've spent my entire time talking to people. This is the first time I've actually stopped and looked at a layout and you've appeared.
Excellent. I'm sorry, but we'll leave you to look in peace. It's been lovely to see you.
And you.
But we're going to go have a little run around and go and annoy people. So where shall we go to first? Let's go this way. We'll see you later, Ari. And here we are. We're next to a few of the other lovely Welsh railways, the Bala Lake, the Thurbourne, all very good friends. And oh, look, the stand's busy. Excellent. Hello, Mike. How's it all been going?
It's been going very well, thank you.
Excellent.
We have a lovely little stand, Christmas cards, calendars all for sale, and a display of our beautiful railway and lovely countryside. What more could you want?
Excellent. So I see we've got, obviously we're always wanting new members at the railway, and looks like there's a special offer on.
We do an offer at the show. The offer comprises two parts. You get 14 months membership for the price of 12. And there's a special offer. We also offer a copy of the Talyllyn Revive book.
Yeah, it's worth £33, and if I'm right, for an adult, the membership is £30.
Correct.
So you're getting your money's worth.
You get quite a good deal. Always round as a show special.
Oh, absolutely. And with that membership, whenever you come to the railway, you get free travel on the trains, and it allows you to come and volunteer at the railway, which is always great fun.
Great fun, indeed.
It is. It's wonderful. But yeah, so we're going to go carry on having a look around, but it's been lovely to see you. Hello, Corwin.
Hello, how are you?
How are you? Very good. I've got a microphone for you now.
Thank you. Are you enjoying yourselves?
I am.
I'm having a great time.
We've not got around much yet. We've come to you guys first.
Oh, really?
Well,
did you follow our map where you had to go all around the whole show first?
No, we've come quite direct.
Oh, that's excellent. I feel blessed. Have you had a goodie bag?
Not yet. Oh, shall we have a look for a goodie bag?
There's a little competition in there. We're doing a scratch card. You might win something. But there's also a little sweetie in there, so everyone wins something.
Oh, excellent. Yeah. Well, yes. Yeah, so come and see the good people at Rapido. Could we have a little look at something that might be quite close to the hearts of Talyllyn members and fans?
Well,
if we can get to the cabinet.
Shall we wander over to the cabinet and have a little look? The elbow away to the front.
Oh, yeah. You've got your name badge on.
Yeah, sorry. This one here, have you heard of it? This is our J70 and Wisp Beach Network coaches. You may recognise the design. Might be familiar to Talyllyn viewers.
Oh yes, especially as we've just been looking at the Audrey layout.
Oh, you've seen the original then?
Oh yes.
Yeah. I think these are slightly different details on them.
A little bit finer.
Yeah. So we've gone for the bogey coaches.
About the same weight.
Yes. I'm counting the amount of times we get asked to do the four-wheelers today. I think I'm about 10.
Good, you should.
Thank you. But we are doing the train packs as well, so you'll be able to buy the C53, which is what it was called in GER days, with the Wisp Beach coaches in their original liveries.
Yeah, brilliant. And another relevant thing to the TR is, of course,
the Tipful Thunderbolt. So this is the painted sample of Dan's coach, which we've just had back from the factory in China. This is quite interesting because it's half tampo printed and half UV printed, which is a process we've not tried before. So the grunge that you see on there isn't a painted on weathering effect, that's actually printed directly onto the coach from a design that we did, because the prop in the film obviously isn't old and weathered, it's a prop. It was made by the film company.
Absolutely.
So to try and replicate that, we've gone for a textured effect, sort of a mottled effect that you have, and then the rubbing of the areas in between the panels and stuff like that.
Let's have a look at the artwork at the top, because Thunderbolt is looking gorgeous in that.
I can't wait to get delivery samples of that back. Yeah, it is gorgeous. I mean, that's the iconic livery, and it's also been a bit of a challenge as well, because you have the diamonds going around the chimney, so you obviously have to try and work out how you're going to print that. I had to unwrap the chimney and work out the diameter and then how many diamonds there were that went around the other side, because I'm that sad.
We appreciate it.
Thank you, mate.
We appreciate
Thank you. I'm so glad someone does. You won't believe how many times I've had to pause stills of the film to try and work it out.
I think
nerdy stuff like that.
We've all done it. And they're having a look at the buffet car there. I see a beer barrel.
No, it can't have a buffet car without a beer barrel. I think it's about a bit shorter than the grasshopper, I'd say, but I'm very adaptable.
Was it an inch and a quarter?
I was trying to think of the measurement.
Of Dan's house is looking excellent.
I think this is going to be, all things being well, and providing that we can get the livery samples back, this might be the first carriage with a fitted carpet. So keep your eyes peeled for that.
I love the candle stand as well.
The candelabra is there. That's going to be nice silver, I hope, to match the one in the film. And then we've got our lovely plates on display on the shelves in the background, because you can't have a buffet car without plates.
Absolutely amazing. And I believe you've had some new announcements today.
I've had a couple of new announcements. Yeah, so they are rotating on our screens at the moment. So if you take a look at the screens, we've got two there. We've got the Y7 from the Northeastern Railway, which is a very popular one. One of our key staff members is a massive fan of the Y7, so it was kind of inevitable this was going to happen. And I think he did quite a lot of training on it. It's also on the big screen if you want to see. We basically put this together for the show just in time. They see it transforming to its lovely lined NER livery, don't get that wrong. Don't want to annoy anyone with that. But of course, it was known as the H-Class in those days. Mm. So that's number 24. And then we're also going to be doing 1310 in the preserved livery that it carries right now. We're doing Lion. We're doing it in two conditions. So Lion changed quite a lot over the years. In the 1930s, when the LMS rebuilt it, or built it, depending on who you talk to, it was released. Didn't have a pressure gauge. So what they found when they were filming the Tipfield Thunderbolt was that hard to keep track of what the pressure in the boiler actually was. So they fitted a pressure gauge, which you can see just on top there. And that stayed on it now. I mean, they've still got one fitted even today. And I think that it was limited to 70 PSI.
Quite
low. It can basically drag itself around, it can drag a couple of coaches around, but you know, it's not being taxed too much. It is a venerable old machine, so you know. I'm really looking forward to seeing that one as well.
I'm looking forward to everything here.
Yeah, it's been a bit of a labour of love, so trying to get painted samples back from the factory, and obviously with COVID restrictions and stuff like that, it's been going on in China, but we're getting there. Hopefully we'll see more appearing in the next few months.
Excellent.
I can't say what they are yet.
Well, no, I'm certainly looking forward to getting my Tipfield pack.
Good. I've actually got two on order. One for best.
Oh, yes. Yes. So, narrow gauge is on everyone's mind, obviously, because you're watching the Talyllyn YouTube channel, and narrow gauge should be on your mind all the time. But Backman, of course, have been leading the charge almost with 009 modelling and narrow gauge modelling. And just in here, we've got the brand new Penryn mainline Hunslets, which are due very soon, I hear, which will not be good for many bank accounts. They look absolutely gorgeous. Of course, those worked on around the Penryn quarries. And latterly on the Festiniog Railway, albeit in a slightly modified form. And if we pop down this end, we've got some more exciting narrow gauge goodness. If we can get in. The absolutely tiny quarry Hunslets. and they look absolutely gorgeous. I've got an Alice on order myself because we've got a rough pup in the museum at the railway, which is the same type, and I'm going to be modifying that to look a bit like rough pup. So there's plenty of variation, so you can get one that suits you best. Thank you very much. And they look absolutely gorgeous. Of course, down below is a neighbouring railway to us again, the Festiniog. They get all the limelight. Harbour Station, new buildings they're coming out with. So that is absolutely gorgeous. Big, isn't it? Back at the layout with the Talyllyn Young Members Group. And this is Nathan. He's on the committee for the Young Members Group.
My apologies to everyone involved.
Exactly, yes. So, yeah, what's the Young Members Group all about?
Well, it's just about getting young members involved. Because, you know, the more young people we have on the TR, it'd be brilliant in the future,
the longer
won't it?
It can keep going,
exactly,
is what we all want.
That's the whole point, isn't it? Longevity, it's been going since the 50s.
So, yeah, it's 14-year-olds to 25-year-olds.
That's correct, yes.
And it's great. We do social events.
Yeah,
and everything. So, yeah.
It's brilliant. It's a lot of fun.
Have you got anything organised for this year, perhaps?
Well, we've got... I've been organising a young members working party, restoring a wagon at Pendry on the... Now, let me think. The 28th and 29th of December, I believe.
That sounds right to me.
Yes.
So if you've been thinking about coming and volunteering, while there's not much going on in December, if you're between 14 and 25,
yeah,
got the Young Members Working Party. Though, of course, they're open to anyone at the railway, not just
Absolutely.
The young members. It's just, it's organised by the Young Members Group. So come along, have some fun, restore a wagon.
It'll be fun, yes. Painting, hopefully. And
brilliant. Well, that's grand. Thank you very much. And as you can see, we've got a nice wide range of people here who've come and travelled. Despite the fact that we all see each other at the railway, have come to see the railway at somewhere else, that's how dedicated we all are. But no, it's great. Well, there we have it. Warley National Model Railway Exhibition. It's been great, and we're not even halfway through it. Hope you've enjoyed the video. See you later. Talyllyn! Excellent. Best echo.